When you go in for major surgery, you will get general anesthesia so that you're unconscious during the surgery. This ensures that you're not going to be aware of what's happening during the procedure, and you also won't remember what happens after the surgery is over, which I'm not mad about. The last thing I would want to remember is a bunch of surgeons poking around inside me with medical instruments. But there is a rare instance where a patient actually wakes up during surgery even though they've received general anesthesia, and they are conscious during the procedure. So what if you woke up during surgery? That's the question we're asking today on Life's Biggest Questions. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. Thanks for checking out another video. I'm Charlotte Dober, and if this is your first time here, subscribe for more questions just like this one. On this channel, we answer one question every single day on a variety of topics, from science to history to horror films and your favorite movie monsters. And make sure you turn on those notifications too so you never miss one of our videos. Anesthesia is a very important part of the medical world. Physician anesthesiologists are some of the most highly skilled experts in the field, and anesthesiologists need to be properly trained, and proper training could mean the difference between life and death. Every person will need a specific amount of anesthesia. Natural redheads, for example, require more anesthesia than the average person because redheads feel more pain than the average person. Don't believe me? It's science. For real, look it up. So if you're a redhead and you're going in for surgery, make sure your anesthesiologist knows that you're a natural redhead. Otherwise, the right amount of anesthesia won't be given to you, and there's a chance you could become conscious during your surgery. People who have fast metabolisms also require more anesthetic. Smokers also could need more anesthetic. One or two out of every 1,000 surgeries involving general anesthesia results in a patient waking up during the procedure. When a patient is conscious during their surgery, it's called anesthesia awareness. Patients who've experienced this are able to remember their surroundings after the surgery, or recall an event related to the surgery itself. This is obviously pretty emotionally upsetting, but the good news is, even though you're awake, you can't feel the pain. You shouldn't feel the pain. Some patients report feeling pressure. Patients who wake up during their surgeries do so with tubes in their mouths and quickly realize that they're connected to IVs and various different medical machines. A lot happens during surgery that patients are unaware of. Doctors and nurses could be having conversations that they definitely didn't want you to hear. Sometimes medical staff will pass out or throw up from the sight of an open body. Imagine seeing a nurse throw up at how gruesome a surgery was, all the while knowing that that surgery was being performed on your own body. If you woke up during surgery, it can be a really traumatic experience. You'll be able to see and hear doctors cutting or carving out chunks of your body. It would be terrifying, like a POV horror movie. If it happens, you have to make sure that you discuss it afterward with your anesthesiologist. In some cases, patients will need to seek counseling to deal with the trauma. You could feel stressed, confused, or disturbed following anesthesia awareness. The worst part of anesthesia awareness is you probably won't be able to let anyone know that you're awake. You can't talk because there's a tube in your mouth. You'll try to move, wiggle your toes or fingers, anything to let the medical team know that you're aware of what they're doing, but they still won't know, and the surgery will carry on. Ever experienced sleep paralysis? Yeah, it'll be kind of like that, except it's actually happening. The only way a doctor could know you're awake during a surgery is if your blood pressure rises, which it usually does when you wake up. Once the doctor has seen that your blood pressure goes up, they would administer more anesthetic to knock you out for the rest of the procedure. Some former patients have reported having post-traumatic stress disorder following anesthesia awareness. Nightmares and flashbacks of the surgery could become a regular thing. Anesthesia awareness is more likely to happen with patients who have multiple medical conditions, or maybe there's a situation where the right dose of anesthesia is actually dangerous, so less is given to the patient. Some examples of procedures like this are an emergency C-section, some types of heart surgery, and surgery that's required after a traumatic injury. Of course, there are some people who wake up during surgery and don't have post-traumatic stress disorder following it. In fact, there are those who actually want to be awake during their surgeries. I know. Crazy, but it's true. Richard Muller, professor of physics at UC Berkeley, is one of them. He asked to be awake during surgery after a mild heart attack, and the surgeon allowed it. The surgeon applied local anesthetic instead of general anesthetic, so Richard didn't feel pain, but he was able to watch the whole procedure. There was a tube inserted into an artery in his arm that the doctors fed into his heart, and then four spreaders were installed that kept his heart wide open. After the surgery, Richard asked to go home, and because he only had local anesthetic, he was allowed to. Obviously, we aren't suggesting to try this, but I thought I would provide an example of someone who was not traumatized by being awake during surgery. It doesn't always have to be a disturbing experience. After all, anesthesia has only been used for the last 200 years. Before the 1840s, the only way to deal with the pain from a medical procedure was by gritting your teeth. For now, I'm Charlotte Dobray, and you've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. To continue watching, why don't you check out the playlist that's clickable on your screen right now, and turn on those notifications by clicking the bell so you never miss one of our videos.